What is an attosecond? 1 attosecond corresponds to 10 to the minus 18 seconds, a billionth of a second. And why is such a short time scale so important? Because this is the natural time scale of electron motion in atoms and molecules. For instance, in the Bohr model of hydrogen atom, the electron rotates around the nucleus with a period of 150 attoseconds in the ground state. So, attosecond pulses allows the real-time observation and even control of electron dynamics in atoms, molecules, and even solids. Attosecond pulses can be generated when an intense laser pulse with an intensity of the order of 10 to the 14 watt per square centimeter interacts with a gaseous method. And this process can be very well understood in the framework of the semi-classical three-step model. In the first step, due to the effect of the external electric field of the laser, the atom is ionized by tunnel ionization. Then, the ejected electron is accelerated in the external electric field and eventually it can recombine with the parent ion, producing the emission of an XUV photon. This process is repeated periodically every half cycle of the external laser field, and this periodicity corresponds to the emission of the other harmonics of the fundamental driving wavelength in the spectral domain. Correspondingly, in the temporal domain, harmonics are emitted as a train of attosecond pulses separated by half the period of the driving laser field. For many experiments that we perform in the lab, this temporal structure is not very effective. In pump probe experiment, we need to select only one attosecond pulse in the attosecond pulse train. This can be done with different techniques. A first approach is the spectral selection of harmonic emission. When the harmonics are generated by very short pulses, in the order of a few femtoseconds, the XUV radiation with the highest photon energy is generated only during the most intense half cycle of the driving beam. One can select the spectral region in the harmonic spectrum, called the cutoff region, for instance with a dielectric mirror. With this approach, isolated attosecond pulses as short as 80 attoseconds in the 80 eV spectral region have been generated. Another possible approach is the temporal gating. In this scheme, the external electric field driving the harmonic generation process is manipulated in time in such a way to isolate only one emission event in the attosecond pulse train. And this can be done in several ways. One way is the polarization gating. In the polarization gating, the confinement of harmonic emission is obtained by changing the polarization of the driving field. The harmonic emission strongly depends on the polarization direction of the driving field and can be strongly suppressed by elliptically polarized driving field, since the electron is driven away from the parent ion and cannot recombine. Thus, an isolated attosecond pulse can be generated if the polarization of the driving pulse is manipulated in such a way that the leading and trailing edges of the pulse are elliptically polarized, while the central portion of the pulse is linearly polarized. Another possible approach for the manipulation of the external electric field can be the combination of different color components in the field. For instance, in the double optical gating, the second harmonic of the driving field is combined with the fundamental driving pulse in order to change the periodicity of the harmonic emission from half the period of the fundamental driving laser to the full period. This scheme can be efficiently combined with the polarization gating in the double optical gating or in the generalized double optical gating approach. Another possible approach for the generation of isolated attosecond pulses is the ionization gating scheme. In this method, the depletion of the gas target in the leading edge of the driving pulse is obtained. And the temporal confinement is the result of the transient phase matching due to the plasma in the medium. All these methods, or a suitable combination of them, have been successfully applied for the generation of isolated attosecond pulses with very short pulse duration and in different spectral regions. All the gating schemes require reproducible external driving field in order to generate reproducible attosecond pulses. This is why, for this method, the stabilization of the carrier envelope phase of the driving laser is required. In a higher harmonic generation process, the maximum photon energy and spectral bandwidth that can be achieved increases with the wavelength squared of the driving laser. Thus, the use of driving lasers with longer wavelength allows the generation of isolated attosecond pulses up to the water window. This spectral region is the one included between the carbon K edge at 280 eV and the oxygen K edge at 540 eV. And this is of particular interest for the study of dynamics in target of biological interest. State-of-the-art isolated attosecond pulses are as short as 50 attosecond and extend in the soft X-ray up to the water window. These pulses give access to the study of electron dynamics, which is the fundamental step of atomic physics and molecular dynamics.